Picture this. You've just woken up in the morning, and the TV isn't working for whatever reason. So, to pass the time, you turn on the radio and tune into your favorite station. But instead of hearing the usual morning DJ, you hear something like this instead.
Good morning, dear listeners. This is WXYZ Radio. Today is May 8, 2023. This morning, the traffic is severe on the highway due to an unusual presence of police cars on the road. But no need to fret. We have some good music to distract you from that disappointment, like we always do. So let's get it on.
Kidding. But imagine hearing this instead.
Good morning, folks. Rise and shine, it's your favorite morning show on WXYZ Radio. Now I have some news for you, and let me tell you, it's like a traffic jam on a roller coaster today. Brace yourselves. The highway is currently experiencing a major blockage due to a, rather bizarre police presence. I mean, seriously, folks, I don't know if they're directing traffic or filming the next episode of Cops Gone Wild. We've got a real-life crime scene over there, and it's causing quite the stir. So if you're stuck in your cars right now, don't worry. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. You're listening to WXYZ, where the unexpected is just another bump in the road. Stay tuned.
As much as he sounds like the annoying morning DJ that you always hear, he's not a human one, to say the very least. He's actually nothing more than an uncanny text-to-speech program powered by artificial intelligence. Observe.
Good morning, folks. Rise and shine, it's your favorite morning show on WXYZ Radio. Now, I have some news for you, and let me tell you, it's like a traffic jam on a roller coaster today. Brace yourselves.
What you just heard was only me fidgeting around with this website called 11 Labs, which is currently the most advanced text-to-speech program out there. But soon enough, you'll hear something like this on the radio in your cars instead of actual human DJs. And it's all thanks, in part, to ChatGPT. In November 2022, OpenAI released their now notorious AI chatbot called ChatGPT to the public. Since then, ChatGPT has grown exponentially popular around the world, and it has been repeatedly touted as the most advanced AI program of its kind. Its popularity has quickly sparked global concerns over artificial intelligence eventually becoming sentient and being able to think for itself in a manner similar to humans. Earlier this year, Elon Musk, Steve Wozniak, and dozens of other technology experts signed a petition calling for a 6-month halt on further AI development, citing multiple risks and concerns if any sorts of regulations and restrictions aren't implemented. Additionally, Geoffrey Hinton, the so-called godfather of AI, announced recently that he would be resigning from his post at Google, citing his own concerns that AI development has suddenly become too rapid for humanity to keep up with. He also expressed concerns about the possibility of shady characters using AI to commit all sorts of heinous crimes. But how would this affect the already dying radio industry? Since this sort of technology is still relatively new and blossoming, there is no possible way of accurately telling exactly what would happen just yet. However, in Cleveland, a local business by the name of Futuri Media recently launched a new product called Radio GPT, which is able to host an entirely automated music radio station. While users maintain control over what music is played, Radio GPT's AI-voiced radio hosts and personalities are specifically powered by GPT-4, which is the same technology that powers ChatGPT.
There's pluses and there's minuses. So I do think that it can help out in certain situations. I would want to write Memorial Day's coming up. So maybe I'm looking for an idea for a specialty weekend and I'm just exhausted about what to do. I can ask, hey, what's a good weekend based on Memorial Day for a radio station? And maybe it'll come up with different patterns. But besides that, you know, I'm from an era where I think the human connection matters.
You might be thinking, this is just a small company. It's not going to affect radio in the long run. But meanwhile, Spotify is doing something similar. Earlier this year, Spotify announced a brand new feature exclusive to premium users. A completely personalized DJ that speaks directly to you, knows what sort of music you like, and makes comments and recommendations for you. This feature is powered by a mix of Spotify's algorithmic system that recommends music to you, OpenAI's GPT technology that writes dialogue for the DJ, and a naturally sounding AI voice similar to 11 Labs. Radio is clearly in trouble, but with all these sudden advancements in AI, radio's troubles could be clearly exacerbated by a long shot. And unfortunately, there is another concern that might not have anything to do with radio, but is still increasingly alarming.
Students are using it to cheat on tests and even write essays.
17% of students admitted to using ChatGPT for help with their final exams.
There are now fears among all sorts of teachers and educators that students will use ChatGPT and other AI programs to cheat in school, particularly with essays.
It's the old adage, you know, if you were cheating off of somebody in school, you're not really learning it for yourself, you know? So if you're relying too much on the AI to do everything for you, then what are you learning for yourself? Do you know what I'm saying? I never saw 2001, A Space Odyssey. So if I wanted to write a little synopsis on it and talk about it, let's say on the air, I could put it into ChatGPT, but I'm only going on what this is telling me. I'm not going on for what my own personal experience was to watch the movie and my own feelings about it. So again, I think if you rely too much on somebody else or something else and you're not learning yourself, you're really only hurting yourself in the long run. I learned about English and I learned about history from, you know, my teachers, and, you know, I read about it and, you know, I did my own research on it. And I think that's kind of fun. What's the fun of just typing in everything and letting somebody else do it for you or something else do it for you? Some people may want to, but, you know, I wouldn't.
To tell you the truth, I wasn't sure how to end this documentary on a conclusive note, especially since this technology is still new. It's still blossoming. But I will say this. Right now, people everywhere are asking the same exact questions. How will this technology affect all sorts of jobs in all sorts of industries, like not just radio, but TV, film, schools, everything in the book? When will this technology affect us in that way? And in the end, who will be responsible for it? But the question we really should be asking ourselves is this. Just because this sort of technology is available to us and open for us to use and build upon, should we even use it in the first place?